Hi everyone, how are you? I'm Vikas again from Vikas Driving School. Today I'm going to show you how to choose a safe gap. If you really like my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel and don't forget to like a video. And please, if you have any concern, please leave a comment and I will make a video accordingly. So I'm going to show you today how you need to choose a safe gap. Choosing a safe gap, you need to keep in your mind 4 points. First point is making a position. It's very important to make a position. If your position is going to be very good, so it will be very easy for you to turn, because you're going to turn very quick. And the second point is you need to be very careful about the safe gap. Safe gap, if you have a safe. And the third thing is timing. And the fourth thing is speed. You need to maintain the speed. If you're going to, suppose you're going to cross front of any car, you need to keep your speed, you keep your speed same. You need to match the speed. If you're not going to match the speed, the gap is going to be finished. So you need to be very careful about these 4 points. So I'm going to repeat again. The first point is making a position. Second point is choosing a safe gap. Third point is choosing a safe gap, and fourth point is maintaining a speed limit. So I'm going to follow this 4 step and going to show you step by step how to choose a safe gap. So here is a T intersection. From this T intersection, I'm going to turn right. No one is coming. Look, first of all, I make my position very nice, and after that I saw there is a safe gap, and after that I just turn. And after that, I just maintain my speed limit. So if the car, if any car is going to come, I can just give little bit accelerator and the gap is not going to be finished. So here is not traffic, but I'm going to show you in more traffic as well how you can choose a safe gap. How you can choose a safe gap. You can stand outside of the road and you can count. You mostly, for the, if you are expert, little bit experienced driver, like 3 second gap is enough. If you are a beginner, you need a 6 second gap. So make sure if you are a beginner, choose a 6 second gap. So 6 second, how you can just stop outside, you can just stand outside of the road and you can just start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Once the car come close to you, then stop counting and then try to observe that gap. That much gap only you need. And the second thing, how if you can cross the road front of the car, you can cross your car as well. So that's how you can observe the safe gap. So now I'm going to choose the 3 second gap. But if you are a beginner, you can choose 6 second. Look, right side is safe, left hand side is safe. Show the left hand side. Car is coming, but I need to maintain my speed as well. If I'm not going to maintain my speed, the gap is going to be finished. So make sure, lots of students, they're getting very confused here. They turn very good, they turn perfectly, but they forget to do maintain the speed limit. Make sure anywhere you're turning, after choosing a safe gap, you need to maintain your speed limit. So I'm going to turn from the side roads now. Look, I'm making my position. I have a very good position. I check both sides. No one is coming. And then I just maintaining the speed limit. And that's all you need to do for turning right on the intersection. In very, very easy to go where there is a no car, where there is a safe, but little bit hard in the traffic. I show you before in the traffic, as now I'm going to show you again. Look, making my position, and after that looking for the safe gaps. Already there is a safe gap, just giving my accelerator, just maintaining the speed limit. Make sure, some student, what they do, they're not giving accelerator. So make sure when you're turning, you need to give your accelerator. So now we're going to turn right on stop sign. Make sure, and the another thing you need to be very careful, just little bit slow down. If there is a stop sign, you need to stop. If there is a no stop sign, you need to slow down for looking. You don't need to continually go on the same speed. You need to slow down for looking for the safety. And after that, I'm checking from my right hand side. When the right side is going to be safe, then I'm going to check left hand side. Right hand side is safe. Left hand side is safe as well. Look, car is turning and the car is coming from 1, 2, 3. So I am maintaining my, because the back side, the white car is coming, but I'm maintaining my speed limit. So the gap will not decrease and the gap will not finish. So that's how you need to choose a safe gap. I'm going to give you a couple of more tips. So now I'm going to turn right front of the car. And make sure, look, the car is coming. Still I have a 7-8 second. I only just need 3 seconds to turning. The car is coming. Still this is very safe gap for me. 1, 2, 3. Only 3 seconds I'm turning. But if you are a new driver, you can use 6 seconds. 6 seconds would be the enough for you to turning comfortably, even you turning slowly. But the trick of this choosing a safe gap is never get confused. If you make a decision, then just don't stop, don't hesitate, just go. And lots of students, what they doing, they're not able to make a decision either they should go or not. So if you think it's safe, go, and don't depend on anyone as well. I saw lots of students, they're taking a lesson from me, they're just waiting for my instruction when I'm going to say to them you need to go. Make sure if you're any learning from anyone, if you're learning from anyone, don't wait for to push you to go. You need to turn yourself, because you're going to build your observation, your confidence. Because if they're going to say to you, you can turn now, you can turn, so that way you're not going to build your confidence. So if you're going to do any mistake, if you're going to do any mistake, they're going to fix it, because they have brake, they have accelerator, and they can stop it. So make sure, always practice make man perfect. Do practice. When you're going to do couple of time this practice, then you're going to observe. Even if you don't have a car, you don't need to have a car to choosing a safe gap. You can just stand outside of the road and you just can start counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that way you're going to count how much 6 second gap is going to be. So that this is the tips to choosing a safe gap. If you still have any question, please don't hesitate to leave a message or comment here. I will really happy to solve your all problem. If you still have any doubt about driving and you getting confused anywhere on any intersection, on any roundabout, please don't hesitate to mention in the comment box. I will make a video accordingly. Thank you so much. And please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and see you soon.